friends, and welcome to another episode of the Urban Homesteading Channel. If this is the first time you're visiting with us, we want to extend to you a very warm welcome. If you've been here before, welcome back. If today is your birthday, we want to wish you a very happy birthday. The holiday season is upon us, and the tradition in everyone's mind is the exchange of gifts in thankfulness for what we have. This year can be challenging. The COVID pandemic has been going on, and sometimes money is tight. And do-it-yourself gifts can be a great solution for you. And sometimes they can be even better than you think. You can go and purchase something from a secondhand store, spend a little bit of time restoring it, cleaning it, make it look brand new, and gift it, and it has more value, it has more meaning, because you spend money and energy on it. Your energy is on that item. You made it. So every time you see that gift when you visit your friend or family, you know this is part of you. You have pride in it, and they know that it's part of you. So I have no problem. I make holiday gifts, and today we're going to show you remaking something into something useful and beautiful from an item that we purchased secondhand. So we're going to show you every step as we usually do.
Yeah, I mean,
the whole bowl was like this, a normal bowl, right?
Mm-hmm.
And there are some that you can have them in both sides.
Right.
And what is this called now that we made it?
This is a yarn or knitting bowl. So the idea is that you have the ball of yarn inside and here, and then the yarn will come out here and feed through here so that it stays. And anybody who does any type of knitting or crochet knows that the yarn ball can go flying across the floor, and this will hold it in place for you.
Okay, and that we're making that for a gift, right?
Yes. Yes.
So
I have just a little bit of touch-up left to do here, and maybe put a little more slope on both of these.
Okay.
And I'll be happy with that.
Looks good.
Do we need to move this so you can see it better?
Okay. So using a Dremel tool, we started with a hand folding saw, right?
Yep.
And using a Dremel tool, we are doing the sanding. And actually this is better than hand sanding because the looplid here has become kind of sensitive, right? You can break it if you put a lot of pressure.
Right.
It takes a little bit of, but how does it feel like, you know?
To do this?
Yeah, is the Dremel the right tool, do you think?
I think so. It's a little bit intricate here, as you said. A little bit intricate through here, but what I'm doing right now is also softening this edge, because when you cut it, it's obviously really sharp, so I'm taking this.
And for the needle, we use a sharpening stone, we're going to take it in a moment, because you cannot. This, even though it's tiny, it's still too big to be in there, right?
Yeah.
And if you find, like we did, if you find that in the secondhand store,
yeah,
you will spend much less money with a little bit of your time than buying it ready, right?
Right.
And if you find the size ready, or they tend to be smaller?
For the actual ones?
Yeah.
No, they tend to be really small, which is why I wanted to get a bigger bowl.
So, you can make a small investment in time.
So I'm going to have to turn this so that I can get the inside too and curve
right.
It.
So you'll make a small investment in time and you'll be able to make a nice gift, right?
Right.
So we have moved to the inside now. And after we're done to our satisfaction with the Dremel, we're going to, you can leave it as it is or you can refinish it, right?
Right.
Then you can touch up the parts that you sanded.
Yeah. Yeah, you could certainly touch up all the parts that you've sanded out if you want. That would be
pretty
easy.
That looks a pretty good finish, actually.
It is a nice finish.
And to me, that looks like walnut. What we said it is? Is it walnut?
It's either walnut or the other one that I had, we talked about, it was teak.
Okay.
I think teak was a...
That looks like walnut. It's not hard. Teak is a hard wood.
Okay.
I mean, walnut is a hard wood, but it's not as hard as teak.
Anyway, so you could definitely touch this up. Obviously, the wood itself needs some cleaning up and some refinishing.
So let us on the other side to show them how we started. I mean, it was... Well, as always, I hope you did enjoy this episode of the Urban Homesteading Channel. And if you did, we'll appreciate a thumbs up. If you didn't, a thumbs down twice will also suffice. Please share, like, subscribe. Let us know what else you might want to watch in these Fast Wednesday videos. From Dr. Wizard and the Urban Homesteading Channel, wash your hands, keep your social distance, wear your mask and get vaccinated. So we're going to see you again soon. Stay safe, friends. So with the advent of the holiday Christmas and everything that's going with the holiday Christmas, erase, bloopers. It's another beautiful North Carolina day and the holiday is all in the air. I do hope you and your family are having a great time, you're staying healthy and safe, and we'll all be able together to get through this pandemic situation we are faced with. As you can see, we have beautiful, beautiful blue skies. My soap is patiently waiting for me. My little forest here, it looks as inviting as ever. And my office is beckoning me for work that I don't want to do.